The coronavirus, creeping onto the world scene only a few short months ago, and then exploding into our day-to-day lives. Every day we hear about the impact of corona and COVID-19 on, well, almost everyone. But how is it affecting disabled individuals? Today on Blind Abilities, we explore just how blind and visually impaired individuals have experienced and adapted to corona and COVID-19. In our previous episodes, we have circumnavigated the world from Australia to Malaysia.
My name is Elise Lonsdale and I'm from Melbourne, Australia.
This is Chi Chow from Malaysia.
England.
Hi, my name is Steve and I'm from England.
Trinidad and Tobago.
Alan Parijo.
And Canada.
Nick D'Ambrosio.
In this, the ninth episode in our series, Around the World with COVID-19 from a Blindness Perspective, we come back to the United States of America.
Lori Thompson, Brooklyn.
Brian Fischler.
Sherry Mullengrapp.
Our guest today is Lori Thompson. Lori is from the Minneapolis, Minnesota area and shares her perspective on how the coronavirus and COVID-19 have affected her, the impact on her work life as an essential worker for the state of Minnesota, and its effect on her personal life around the house, traveling, and elsewhere. And now, please welcome our guest, Lori Thompson.
Late this afternoon, the Department of Health confirmed Minnesota's first case of COVID-19.
State officials said they were ready, they were prepared. They tell us an older adult tested positive in Ramsey County.
That was Friday, March 6th. Patient number one was over 65 years old and likely got COVID-19 while traveling on a cruise to Mexico. 4 days later, a person in their 30s became patient number two, hospitalized in critical condition. After that news, things would start to change very quickly.
There are now more than 3,700 confirmed coronavirus cases in the United States. 54 of those confirmed cases are in Minnesota. No one in Minnesota has died from the virus.
More than 400 people have now tested positive for the coronavirus in our state.
Hi, my name is Lori Thompson. I live in Minneapolis, Minnesota, which is in the United States. I just want to share with you how the COVID-19 pandemic has affected my life in the last few months. I'm very fortunate because I have been working. I am considered an essential worker for the state of Minnesota. And in March, when the pandemic was known to be here in the United States, my office decided to do a staggered schedule with the office people. So I've been working from home some days and going into the office some days. The public transit went to a shortened schedule. The buses were not running early enough for me to get to my job at the right time. And also, with the high risk of becoming infected, I decided not to take public transit. I'm very lucky that my children live here with me and they both drive, and their schedules have allowed them to help me get to and from work. Also, I do have a coworker that lives close by. If she works on the same days I do in the office, she's willing to pick me up and bring me home. So that's been very helpful. Working from home, you know, I'm not a techie person, so it can be challenging when the computer doesn't want to work properly. I've had to use Skype more, which is not a bad thing. I was familiar with Skype, but I wasn't an avid user of Skype, so it's been a learning curve for me. Also, Zoom is another thing I was familiar with, and I used it somewhat, but I wasn't an avid user of Zoom. The hardest thing is when you're having computer issues and your computer doesn't want to work right. I can't just call an IT guy in to my office here at home and say, can you please fix this? I have to submit a ticket and then they typically remote in. So it's a little different. And I think with the COVID-19, I think it's paving the way for how we're going to do things in the future. Another thing with COVID-19, it's been hard to go shopping, Instacart or a delivery service. You have to order your groceries 3 or 4 days in advance.
Lawmakers are cracking down on the spread of COVID-19 with new executive orders. Here's what happened today. President Donald Trump declared a national emergency. Minnesota Governor Tim Walz declared a peacetime emergency. New tonight, the Minnesota Department of Health says the state does not have enough tests for those who want them. And in Wisconsin, Governor Tony Evers is closing all public and private schools.
Early on with the pandemic in March, it was kind of scary, you know, not knowing how long this pandemic was going to last. You know, there was a lot of question marks in the very beginning when all of this started. Thank goodness things have kind of relaxed a little bit. We now know that the grocery stores are going to have what we want. It's just unfortunately, the price of everything is going to go up. And now people are starting to go back to work with definite policies and procedures in place for the safety of everyone. We can have more people in the office, but we have to keep the social distance. We have to wear a mask when we're in community areas, only 2 people in the elevator at a time. We're still not open to the public, but I'm okay with that, really. But I think it's good that we're pushing people to do more things online, which it should be that way anyway. And I'm very fortunate that my office is putting these policies and procedures in place for my safety and my coworkers' safety. And unfortunately, I think this is the way it's going to be for a while. The hardest thing for me with the COVID-19 is not being able to go anywhere. I love to take vacations. I love to go see my family, which live in another state. I like to go on an airplane and fly somewhere. And that's been really hard for me because I would have already probably went on a couple trips already. But it's okay because, you know, we're staying at home. We're doing alternative things. Instead of taking big trips, we're camping or hiking. You know, we're taking little day trips here and there away from people.
Coming to you from Pelican Lake in the northwestern part of Minnesota. A beautiful day here on Sunday. Getting outdoors, enjoying the great outdoors, still a really big priority, I know, for a lot of families out there, even in the midst of everything going on with COVID-19.
Just be sure you're understanding what you're getting into for this kind of new experience. But the fun experience is still there. It's just gonna look a little different.
Explore Minnesota has been offering up some really good options for you and your family to check out. They say visit one of the 75 state parks and trails all across the state. A reminder that there are 4,000 miles of paved bike trails in Minnesota. Consider checking out one of the many drive-in movie theaters in Minnesota.
So it's okay. You know, it's the things that we have to do to get through this terrible time, and it's working out. I've spent a lot more time reading and cooking, a lot more time cooking. I live in a city where there's a fast food place on every corner, so it was very easy for me to, you know, hey, go pick up Taco Bell, or hey, let's get a pizza tonight. I've had to open up my cookbook and go back to the times when my kids were little and I wasn't working and making more food that way. And it's brought us all to the kitchen table at night for supper instead of grabbing my taco and sitting at my desk or the kids going down to their room. Another thing that's been really hard during this time is I am a guide dog user and I haven't been able to use Logan like I should be. He's not getting the exercise that he needs. I've had to watch his food intake because he's not getting out as much. We do try to take some walks in the neighborhood and we play outside, but it's just still not the same. The days that I do go in, sometimes I'll take him in with me. Sometimes I don't. He's not really being worked because he's in a car, you know? So it's been hard on Logan, but it's gonna be okay, isn't it, buddy? Yeah. I know that this COVID-19 is a very unfortunate thing, and I've heard this before from other people. I think it has made us stop and take a breath and check ourselves, you know? What have we been doing? These are some things that I wanted to share with you that has affected my life during the COVID-19. I hope everybody is staying safe physically and mentally. There is light at the end of the tunnel, and hopefully we can get there soon. Hopefully we can all come out of this stronger and healthier. Thank you.
Tonight, Minnesota Governor Tim Walz loosened some of the COVID-19 restrictions that have shut down business here for months.
That's some good news, but it may not be enough to ease massive unemployment around the state.
Health officials say they're noticing a dramatic shift in the demographics of who's testing positive for COVID-19 in the city.
It's really playing Russian roulette.
The Minnesota Department of Health today not pulling punches, reminding young adults COVID-19 poses a threat to you, too.
I know that we talk about the groups that are at highest risk for complications of COVID, and age has something to do with that, but that does not mean that younger individuals do not have serious illness.
Illness is infectious disease director Chris Erisman said, and even deaths, including in Minnesota, 3 otherwise healthy 20-year-olds. Erisman also noted the youth trend may be due in part to parties, bonfires, even cabin weekends. And as bars and restaurants remain possible hotspots, state health leaders also say they'll keep watching whether to roll back any reopening measures.
It was great hearing from Lori today and hearing of her experiences with Corona and COVID-19 in the Minneapolis, Minnesota area. Be sure to listen to more episodes in our series, Around the World with COVID-19 from a Blindness Perspective. And from all of us here at Blind Abilities, through these challenging times, to you, your family, and friends, stay well, stay informed, and stay strong. Thank you so much for listening, and have a great day.
When we share
what we see through
each other's eyes, we can then begin to bridge the gap between the limited expectations and the realities of blind abilities.
For more podcasts with a blindness perspective, check us out on the web at www.blindabilities.com, on Twitter at Blind Abilities, download our app from the App Store, Blind Abilities, that's two words, or send us an email at info@blindabilities.com. Thanks for listening.